What's up everybody, Nate here. So today we'll look at another raid boss that was up for testing on the beta servers, the Spirit Kings. I do have to remind you again, this is an early look at the encounter, and no matter how many times I say it, we'll still have trolls wanting to re-explain to you that this boss was pretty much killed by everybody and their grandma and that WoW sucks. The only thing I can ask from you is that you don't feed them too much. So as we overview the encounter, the Spirit Kings are made up of four bosses, with individual health pools for each with their own abilities, and you face them in a random order. Now, before the encounter starts, only one mob will be active and roaming around the room, and that's the boss that you'll start the encounter with. The other bosses will be around the room in their spirit form and unattackable. Again, I need to explain that the encounter is you only face one boss at a time, and that order can be completely random. The bosses that you face are named individually Meng, Subtai, Xian, or Quang. Now, as I explained before, each boss has their own specific abilities, but what I didn't tell you is that each boss, after it has been defeated, will continue to do one of their abilities while being banished back to their spirit realm and unattackable. So let's dive straight into it then. Meng himself has four abilities, with the most important one being Maddening Shout. Now, Maddening Shout is an ability that makes Meng do 30k damage over 3 seconds to everybody in the raid, and also turning you against everybody else in the raid, until you take a further 10k damage from friendly fire. Now, Meng's further abilities just revolve around him making his cowardice ability stronger through his insanity, and there really isn't much to worry about it. Now, the thing you have to worry about is Maddening Shout, which is the one ability Meng will continue to cast throughout the fight. Now, the boss you might face next is Quang, and he has three abilities under his belt. First being the ability that will continue after death, called Flanking Orders. Now, when Quang casts Flanking Orders, he calls a wave of Mogu attackers that could be anywhere around the room in a wave to slowly make their way through the room, dealing 600,000 physical damage to anybody that comes in contact with them. Now, along with this ability, he also has Annihilate, which is a frontal cone shockwave-like ability that we've seen in the past, but this time one-shots. And he'll also gain from the start of combat buff on him that requires both tanks to be in front of him at all times to share his melee swings. One of the other bosses that you'll be able to face is Sebtai, who is very hunter-like in all three of his abilities. His first ability is the one that will carry on past his death, which is Pillage, where he'll charge to a random target in the room, stealing anybody's gear who's within his range when he starts spinning on that spot, and also reducing their healing done by 50%. His last two abilities are Volley and Rain of Arrows and can be cast randomly throughout the fight, but can be dodged by simply moving away from wherever he chooses to fire them at. Now, the last boss that you'll face is Xian, who has one pretty complex mechanic, along with two simple ones, one of which can be easily interrupted. Xian's main mechanic is that he will periodically cast Undying Shadows at a location of a random target, summoning an Undying Shadow that needs to be killed and will leave a pool of shadow behind when killed that damages over time. You've guessed it. This is also the ability that he will continue to cast through death for the rest of the fight. After some time, the shadow pool will reform and reform to an Undying Shadow again, which can reattach to a player and chase the player around, meaning that it will need to be killed again. There is, however, a maximum number of Undying Shadows that can be active at any one time, which currently stands at 3 on 10 man. Xian's other abilities aren't that important. One of them can even be interrupted, Shadow Blast, and the other, Charged Shadows, just is something for the healers to heal up. Now, we went into this fight having done our homework a little bit, and just as normal, we were able to easily heal it with 3 healers and 2 tanks. Many guilds managed to defeat the encounter, and pretty much the general census is that it's undertuned. That being said though, it's going to be very easy for them to change certain mechanics or certain values and turn it into a really complex fight. that's about all I have for this one. There is nothing much really to cover in it as it is undertuned. I hope you managed to take something away from it as always, and make sure you subscribe to the MMO Champion YouTube channel.